Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
We are so blessed to have you here.
Thank you very much.
Sir, can you please tell us how relevant is the vision of TASEF to the African church as a whole?
Yes, thank you very much. What the TASEF is doing today, I know TASEF has been on ground for some years now. They are assisting the church to fulfill the vision of God concerning the church. The Lord says to go and preach the gospel to every creature. Now what the TASEF brethren are doing by the grace of God, in fact, I'm calling them the evangelical arm of the church, because by the grace of God, they have been able to reach the unreached. They have been able to do even what the church cannot do now. The TASEF brethren, by the grace of God, they have been able to take the gospel beyond the shores of the African church, even beyond the shores of Nigeria. By the grace of God, in what we have seen today, the TASEF brethren, they have been able to fulfill the purpose of God on behalf of the African church. So as I said before, I'm just saying it now, the TASEF brethren that God has given them to the church as a blessing.
So sir, TASEF is a blessing to the African church. What is your fatherly counsel for TASEFites all over the world?
Yes, my brothers and sisters who are members of the African Church Evangelical Fellowship, my advice to all of them is they should continue in their good works. Because I believe what they are doing, since they are being propelled, since they are being guided by the Spirit of the Lord, since they are being empowered by the Holy Spirit, I know they will never stop in hard way. My advice to them is to continue to seek the face of the Lord. It's to continue to seek the counsel of the Lord. It's to continue to rely on Him, rely on the ability of God, to rely on the power of God, to rely on the efficacy of the prayer of believers. Because I believe our prayer works. When brethren gather together to seek the face of the Lord in two prayers, it works miracles. Because I have seen what I have seen here today. It's an evidence that God is really working through prayers. Because Nigeria is talking about recession. Everybody's complaining of hardship. Everybody's complaining of things being too difficult. But coming here now, I have seen that God has broken the yoke of recession in our midst. He has broken the yoke of poverty in our midst. That God has removed all obstacles, all barriers. So let them keep on trusting the Lord. Let them keep on doing the will of the Lord, because the sky will not even be the limit. I believe God is taking us to a level that our generation will live to glorify the name of the Lord.
And to round up the interview, can we have your fatherly heartfelt prayer for TASEFites all over the world?
Our brothers and sisters in TASEF, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost upon my life, I declare over your life that it shall be well with all of you. The Bible says that God is our shield, is our glory, is the lifter up of our head. The glory of the Lord will overshadow all of you in the name of Jesus. The Lord shall preserve all of you. The Lord shall protect all of you. God's goodness and mercy shall be upon you all in the name of Jesus. None of you shall labor in vain. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, all of you shall succeed in all your human endeavors. By the Spirit of the Lord, I declare over your lives that no activity of the wicked shall prosper over your lives in the name of Jesus. You shall live to fulfill the purpose of God in your lives in the name of Jesus. And I declare over your lives that by the power of God's Spirit, you will excel in every area of life. And you will live to be vessels of honor unto the Lord, and also people to be reckoned with in our generation to the glory of the Most High God. I declare in Jesus' name. Amen.
God bless you, sir.
To a great house. I serve a great God. I have a great future. I am a holy and honorable vessel. I am furnished for greater works and destined for greatness, because the greatness of the great God is at work in me.